When two competitors set up shop right across the street from each other, it makes for a very revealing direct comparison of the brand experiences. So today, we'll be looking at the Nike and the New Balance stores in the Flatiron District of New York City. I'll start with the New Balance store. It's on the ground floor level, 4,000 square feet. Across the street, the Nike store is a 9,000 square foot two-level spot. What's instructive about each of these stores is the distinctive brand experience at each. New Balance's brand is about its 105-year-old history, its made-in-America manufacturing, and its mainstream appeal. So the store features a ceiling-mounted timeline with highlights from the company's history, and the fixtures are made of old-school materials and designs. The store designers left the building's original wood floors and columns untouched, and a company spokesperson said that the historic Flatiron District was selected as the location for the store since, quote, "we really feel like the culture of New Balance is a great fit here." As a reflection of the brand's accessibility, the store seemed quite playful and fun, with products in all sorts of bright colors on display. The highlight of the store is a unique demonstration area, decorated with old photos and outfitted with historical-looking equipment. In it, custom-designed shoes are assembled in front of customers. The interactivity and authentic feeling of the demo area make a strong positive impression and gives the brand a craftsman feel. Nike's brand, on the other hand, is more about innovation, technology, and environmentally proactive practices. So the Nike running store prominently incorporates digital elements such as an innovation wall that highlights videos of Nike's products, and special displays showing off the Nike Fuel Band and Nike Plus. When I visited, signage was promoting the product technology Hypershield. In keeping with Nike's environmental stewardship, the store uses reclaimed building materials, including a wooden bleacher from a local college, and was designed to receive LEED Gold certification. Also, the store participates in Nike's Reuse a Shoe program, which recycles customers' old donated shoes into new products. The outdoor signage at each store serves as a summary of the difference between the two brands. New Balance's windows were covered with decals in a classic font promoting New Balance Inc., manufacturers of fine quality footwear, while neon lights flashed NYC and Run in Nike's windows. Now, the Nike store is not all high-tech and void of a human feel. Its two-story wall features a hand-drawn mural. And the New Balance store isn't all earthy crunchy. It presents several innovative elements, including a small indoor running track for runners to try out shoes, and it's equipped with a camera that's rigged to take your picture so you can post it on your Facebook page. This was actually a much more innovative and distinctive approach than the standard treadmills at Nike. There was one more noticeable difference between the stores, the employees. While some of the New Balance employees seemed like appropriate running ambassadors, the store greeter was rather large, and he was friendly, but that presented an immediate brand disconnect for me, and the cashier kind of seemed bored. At Nike, every employee seemed like a passionate running expert. I can't say I favored one store over the other. Both delivered compelling brand experiences in their own way, and perhaps that's the biggest takeaway from this brand experience brief. Compelling store experiences depend on bringing clear brand values and attributes to life in creative ways.